Good evening. Welcome to the Election Caravan. I'm Shireen Bhan. India will start voting in 8 days. And tonight, we take you inside rural Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Parikshit Luthra joins us from Baghpat in western UP, where sugarcane farmers hold the keys to power. Archana Shukla has been travelling inside Maharashtra and she has now reached Bid. Jude Sanith is at the southernmost tip of India in Kanyakumari, where BJP's only Lok Sabha MP in Tamil Nadu is facing the richest candidate in the state. Parikshit, Archana and Jude, thanks very much for joining us on the Election Caravan. Parikshit, to you first, your travels through the sugarcane belt of UP. What are the key issues for farmers so far that you've come up against?
We're right now in Baghpat area of western Uttar Pradesh. This goes to polls on the 11th of April and we're standing in sugarcane fields right now, Shireen. And this issue will be very important, the plight of sugarcane farmers. We met them earlier in the day. They are complaining about the fact that they are not being paid their dues on time. Sugar mill owners here tell us that there is a vicious cycle. The prices of sugar have been going down consistently in the last 5 years and they just don't have enough funds to pay the farmers. And the government really needs to think hard to bring them out of their plight. Here's our interaction with sugarcane farmers in Malakpur Mill in Baghpat earlier today. We are in Badoth area of Baghpat in western Uttar Pradesh. This used to be the bastion of Chaudhary Charan Singh and the Rashtriya Lok Dal. But in 2014, RLD and Ajit Singh lost this seat and also Muzaffarnagar to the BJP. This time, however, sugarcane farmers could play a decisive role. We are told that the mill owners in this area of Muzaffarnagar, Baghpat, Meerut and all these 8 or 9 districts of western UP have not been paid their dues to the tune of 10,000 crore rupees. Let's get in a word from some of the farmers here. Bhai sahab, hum aapse janna cha rahe hain ki jo aapne kisan, jo aapne गन्ना मिल को बेचा उसके लिए आपको पैसा कितने दिन में मिला
अब के पिछले साल हमें मिला 14 महीने में
14 महीने
जी
और कहते सरकार क्या कहती है कि 14 दिन में मिलना चाहिए
रूल भी यही है कि 14 दिन पेमेंट मिलना चाहिए किसान को और लेकिन हमें कभी 14 दिन में नहीं मिलता
कभी 14 दिन में नहीं मिलती भाई साहब ये जो बात है कि किसान को पैसा टाइम पे नहीं मिलता 10,000 करोड़ हम सुनते हैं कि अभी ड्यू है
10,000
करोड़
इससे नाराजगी है किसानों में
हाँ पूरी नाराजगी है इससे किसानों में और जो है पेमेंट का सुधार तो हुआ पर इतना नहीं जितना ये लोग वादा करते हैं इतना सुधार नहीं हो पाया सुधार योगी सरकार ने किया तो पर इतना नहीं जितना होना चाहिए था
भाई साहब अगर आपसे जानना चाहें कि जो गन्ना किसान है इस बार जब अपना वोट देने जाएगा अपना मतदान करने जाएगा तो किस मुद्दे पे वोट करेगा
गन्ने के पेमेंट ना होने पर गन्ने का जो पेमेंट टाइम पर नहीं हुआ एक साल का गन्ने का पेमेंट इस साल का फिर रोक लिया गन्ने का सभी फैक्ट्रियों में शुगर फैक्ट्रियों में गन्ने का मेन मुद्दा रहेगा गन्ने के सोच के ऊपर इसके सरकार
परेशानी होती है कि जब टाइम पे ना मिले
हाँ परेशानी होती है बच्चों की फीस नहीं जाती मेडिकल नहीं करा पाते हम अपने अपने घर का मतलब डांगरू की दवा नहीं ले पाते बाल की दवा नहीं दवा पाते तो इतने परेशान है किसान के बिन चक्री परेशान है
भाई साहब अगर आपसे जानना चाहें जो मुजफ्फरनगर बागपत और इस इलाके के जो किसान हैं पेमेंट ना होने के वजह से क्या परेशानी पड़ती है आपके लिए
परेशानी यही है जी हम बिजली का बिल नहीं भर पाते अपना और अपने खर्चे नहीं चला पाते जाक तू भी फीस नहीं दे पाते एक दूसरे मदद लेकर पूर्ति करें अपनी
जो इस बार वादे किए जा रहे हैं जो वादे किए जा रहे हैं भाजपा और सरकार का कहना है कि उन्होंने एक नई स्कीम ले आए हैं 6,000 रुपये किसानों के अकाउंट में जाएंगे उससे कुछ फर्क पड़ेगा आपको लगता है
जेका जी मेरी बात सुनो आप सबसे पहले एक आप तो ये जो गाय की और ये बछड़े जो इनका इनकी व्यवस्था करो आप सबसे पहले ठीक दूसरी
फसल नष्ट होती है
जी मुझे किसानों की फसल बर्बाद हो जान से अच्छा
दूसरी गाय के चरने से
जी अच्छा जी
गाय के एक के चरने से नहीं झुंड के चरने से
झुंड हो जा जी बहुत काफी झुंड हो जा अच्छा फिर उसमें दूसरी बात ये हमारा जो खाद था उसमें 5 किलो खाद कम कर दिया उसमें पैसे बढ़ा दिए फिर दूसरी बात होगी जी बिजली का बिल बढ़ा दिया गैस का सिलेंडर पे पैसे बढ़ा दिए तो कैसे पूर्ति होगी जैसे
तो इस 6,000 रुपए जो आते हैं उससे कुछ फर्क पड़ेगा
इससे कोई लाभ नहीं हो पाओगा 6,000 रुपए में क्या होगा 6 रुपए में एक डीएपी का कट्टा नहीं आता 2 डीएपी कट्टे नहीं आते 6,000 रुपए में 6,000 में कोई लाभ नहीं
और जो कांग्रेस का कहना है कांग्रेस का कहना है कि किसान का बजट लाया जाएगा
बजट बजट क्या हो भाई, ये नहीं पता क्या बजट हो, बजट कितना देंगे सरकार लो बताओ, कितना बजट देगी वह सरकार ये बताओ, हमें तो ही नहीं पता बजट कितना देगी।
आपके लिए बस यही है कि गन्ने का भुगतान टाइम पे होए।
हम किसी का फ्री का नहीं चाहते, हमें तो सिर्फ मारा ही मिल जाओ वही बते रहा हूँ। हम फ्री का खाने वाले ना आए किसान, दोपहर में काम करते हैं गर्मी में, हमें तो मारा ही मिल जाओ अगर नहीं, हमें फ्री का एक रुपया नहीं चाहता।
ओके, दैट्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट मैसेज। फार्मर्स हियर सेइंग दे हैव अ लॉट ऑफ प्राइड, दे डोंट वांट एनीथिंग फॉर फ्री, एंड व्हाट दे वांट इज द राइट प्राइस फॉर शुगर केन and price to be paid on time within a period of 14 days as successive governments have promised. We have been speaking to different mill owners and they tell us that the industry is caught in a vicious circle. They have to purchase sugarcane compulsorily from the farmers, but at the same time they're not able to clear dues in 14 days and sometimes it could take even up to 14 months. The reason being the industry is going through a slowdown. Byproducts of sugar has also been going down. Molasses, for example, were going for 1 rupee per quintal in the last financial year. And this is the reason why most of the mill owners in Uttar Pradesh are not able to clear the dues on time. They say there is a vicious circle and these farmers are caught in that vicious circle as well. Mill owners also saying that the government should now start focusing on ethanol production because that is what will eventually save the farmers. Most of these farmers say that they are fine with whatever product or byproduct mill owners want to make for their benefit, but they should get their money on time.
That is an important message coming in there from Baghpat in Western Uttar Pradesh. Remember, this goes to elections in the first phase, which starts on the 11th of April. This is not about how farmers intend to vote, whether they will vote for the incumbent or not. This is about the issues that matter to the Indian farmer. That important statement coming in there, we are not freeloaders. We don't want anything for free. We want what we are due, what is due to us. And remember, it's been 14 months that sugarcane dues have not been cleared, at least as far as some farmers are concerned. Also saying very clearly that whether it's the PM Kisan scheme of 6,000 rupees, it doesn't really change the fortunes as far as the farming community is concerned. And the cow menace, this is a big issue. This has been a big cause for concern for the agriculture sector, for the farmers across states, and farmers in UP calling that out as well. Well, we'll now head to Maharashtra. Archana Shukla in Bir. You were in Ahmednagar earlier, which will see a fierce battle between two of the most influential families in the city. Archana, what are people talking about in Ahmednagar? You just heard what people are saying in Western UP, in Baghpat. What's the mood like in Ahmednagar?
Well, Shireen, what we heard in Baghpat is also somewhere seen in Maharashtra, in rural Maharashtra, which is dealing with severe drought. But for Ahmednagar particularly, the issues are that of jobs and employment. But it's going to be a very, very interesting seat because it's a fierce and an interesting battle. It's the seat which will see two of the youngest candidates coming face to face, and that could be the seat which could give India one of its youngest parliamentarian. NCP's Sangram Jagtap, who's the current MLA, is fighting against Congress rebel Sujay Vikhe Patil, whose father, Radhakrishna Patil, actually is a star campaigner for Congress. Even R. Gandhi's son, who's the current MP, his son Suvendra Gandhi has indicated that he may file his nomination as an independent. So it could be the battle of the sons and also a battle of the influential families. But for the people in Ahmednagar, the issues are core of employment. There are multiple education institutions owned by these politicians in Ahmednagar, but the MIDC, which is one that has to create jobs, has not been expanding to the extent that it could. I stopped by in one of the key chowks in Ahmednagar to sip on some chai and talk to some of the youngsters and people there listening to that conversation. Ahmednagar is turning out to be an interesting election fight this time. It's a family that's fighting as well as supporting each other, both from Congress and BJP. It's also one of the oldest towns here in Maharashtra. One of the towns where the entire sugarcane cooperative actually started. We thought to visit the city, find out from the people what really is on the minds when they would go to vote this time and what really is happening on ground. We came to this place called Mauli Shankul in Jhopadi Canteen Road. This is what it is called here locally, this region in the city of Ahmednagar. And I was told the tea here is very good. So I thought I'll sip on some tea and maybe chat up with a few people over here. भाई साहब कुछ ग्रीन टी वगैरह मिलती है यहाँ पे हमने सुना बड़ी अच्छी है हमें पिलाएंगे इसमें क्या तुलसी वगैरह भी डाला है क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग आप लोग चाय नहीं पी रहे चाय पी के हो गया क्या आप लोग आपका शहर तो बड़ा फेमस हो रहा है पूरे कंट्री में बहुत माहौल यहाँ पे बन रहा है इलेक्शन का
माहौल इसलिए बन रहा है जब हम देश का ये सोचते हैं तब बीजेपी कांग्रेस ये होता है हमारे यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा अलग है कांग्रेस से बीजेपी में जो अभी उम्मीदवार हमारे गए हैं वो उनके पिताश्री कांग्रेस के महाराष्ट्र विधानसभा के विरोधी पक्ष नेता है इसलिए पूरे महाराष्ट्र में पूरे देश में हमारा ये जो अहमदनगर दक्षिण लोकसभा मतदार संघ है वो बहुत मतलब चर्चा उसकी हो रही है मतलब कॉमेडी लग रहा है लोगों को क्या क्या चल रहा है यहाँ पे कॉमेडी चल रही है क्या कॉमन लोगों का मतलब ले नहीं रहा है कोई कि मैं कौन सा पक्ष में जाऊँ क्या करूँ तो इसलिए चर्चा ही होगी
जितना कुछ होना चाहिए था इंडस्ट्रियली या अदरवाइज डेवलपमेंट वो नहीं हुआ है जितना हम एक्सपेक्ट करते ये जो पूना औरंगाबाद या नासिक ये सिटीज हमारे बाद में आके बहुत ज़्यादा डेवलप हुई है वैसे ये शहर बहुत पुराना है तो उस हिसाब से कुछ हुआ नहीं है और ये जो अभी बात कर रहे थे कि कांग्रेस में से इधर आए वैसे तो पूरे इंडिया में इट्स बीजेपी वर्सेस कांग्रेस या मोदी वर्सेस राहुल हमारे यहाँ वैसा नहीं है हमारे यहाँ पार्टी कौन सी पार्टी में किसी को मालूम नहीं है ये फाइट है विखे वर्सेस जगताप
यहाँ पे मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर यहाँ पे ग्रेजुएट लड़के लड़कियाँ कंपनी में हेल्पर का जॉब कर रहे हैं आप एमआरडी से जाकर देखो तो और क्या बात करेंगे हम यहाँ पे बाकी स्टूडेंट है जो आपसे बात करेंगे इस विषय पर
किस तरह का यहाँ पर जॉब सिनेरियो क्या पढ़ रहे हैं आप अभी क्या करना चाहते हैं आगे
मैं भी जर्नलिज्म का पढ़ाई कर रहा हूँ तो जब से ये अहमदनगर एरिया ऐसा है कि इधर जो भी अभी एमपी के लिए जो जो, जो उम्मीदवार खड़े हैं उनके बड़े बड़े इंस्टीट्यूट्स है ये एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स तो प्रॉब्लम इज दैट कि हम लोग यहाँ पे पढ़ाई करते हैं बड़े बड़े इंस्टीट्यूट्स है ये सब पॉलिटिशियंस की मतलब दोनों की भी और हमको जब जॉब की बात आती है तो हमको पुणे जाना पड़ता है
जॉब के बारे में तो फिलहाल जो सिचुएशन है अभी या इस ईयर के बारे में या कहीं भी जगह जाओ तो जॉब की बहुत खतरनाक सिचुएशन है यानी कि पहले तो जॉब की जो एडवर्टाइज निकलने चाहिए यानी जो नौकर भर्ती आप बोलते हैं तो वो होती नहीं कभी कभी एड पब्लिश होती है लेकिन एड पब्लिश होने के बावजूद वो प्रक्रिया पूरी नहीं हो पाती इसकी वजह से ये जो आपकी जो स्टूडेंट यानी कि जो क्वालिफाइड है वो भी बहुत सारे वैसे ही रह चुके हैं तो बहुत बेकार हालत हो चुकी है
लेट मी टेक सम मोर व्यूज फ्रॉम द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर हियर आप लोग स्टूडेंट्स से पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं राइट क्या आपको लगता है यहाँ पर जब आप अभी पढ़ाई करके बाहर निकलेंगे नौकरी के प्रावधान क्या है यहाँ पर कुछ अच्छी अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैं आपको लगता है सरकार यहाँ पे नौजवानों के लिए कुछ अच्छा काम कर रही है
नौजवानों के लिए काम कर रही है ऐसा मुझे तो नहीं लगता है क्योंकि देश में ना मैं चौकीदार नाम का ट्रेंड शुरू है लोग चौकीदार बनने के लिए तैयार है लोगों के लिए जो दो करोड़ रोजगार देने की बात कर रहा था वो आज लोगों को है ना ट्रेंड में मैं चौकीदार ट्रेंड में शामिल कर रहे
है भाजपा जो है अगर उनको हम चुन के लाएंगे हम सबको पता है यहाँ पे कौन चुन के आने वाले मोदी आने वाले चुन के ये सबको पता है
मुझे एक बात बताइए आपके शहर की बात करते हैं देश को छोड़ दीजिए नौकरियां बनी है आपके शहर
नहीं, नहीं नहीं वो नहीं बनी
आप वोट दो लेकिन ये बात गलत है कि नरेंद्र मोदी को देख के वोट दो क्योंकि नरेंद्र मोदी पंतप्रधान है वो पंतप्रधान ही रहेंगे और दूसरा अभी चेंज होगा तो वो भी पंतप्रधान ही रहेंगे वो यहाँ पे आके काम नहीं करेंगे यहाँ पे जो लोकल में हम अच्छा खासदार चुनेंगे वही काम करेंगे अहमदनगर में और फिर उसके बाद ही अहमदनगर का विकास होगा
मोदी वर्सेस राहुल या मोदी वर्सेस कोई और नहीं हो रही ये निवडणूक मोदी विरुद्ध आम जनता और गरीब जनता इनके बीच हो रही है इसलिए मुझे लगता है कि आम जनता ही जीत जाएगी लोकतंत्र में आज तक का भारतीय नागरिक इतना मजबूत है और होशियार है कि उन्होंने जब जब उन पर प्रॉब्लम बिताए तो उन्होंने सही
मार्क निकाला है।
तो आप कह रहे हैं यहाँ पर मोदी वर्सेस राहुल या बीजेपी वर्सेस कांग्रेस नहीं है?
नहीं है, तो वो आम आदमी विरुद्ध मोदी है, लोग मोदी को हार देंगे, आम आदमी जीतेगा।
आम आदमी कॉमन मैन की जीत होगी। वेल दैट्स अ वेरी गुड नोट टू एंड दिस डिस्कशन ऑन। The young friend here says that the common man in India is intelligent enough to figure out who's working for them and who's not working for them. And according to him, it is a fight between the existing government versus the common man. And if that is his personal view, whether BJP comes to power or not. But let me just sum it up for you. The biggest issues in Ahmednagar that we came across was one biggest, and that is of job creation. There are no local jobs. Migration is a big problem. There are lots of educational institutions here giving higher education and degrees to students, but no jobs. And possibly, at least for the younger crowd here, that will be the biggest issue that will be on their minds before they go to vote. But obviously, this will be a constituency to watch out for the very, very interesting turns as far as candidate nominations are concerned from this city. With camera person Bharat Kori, this is Archana Shukla for CNBC-TV18.
Well, that's Archana Shukla there reporting from Ahmednagar. And once again, such important takeaways that in television studios, the election looks like it's Prime Minister Modi versus the Congress President Rahul Gandhi. But look at what people are telling you on the ground. Eventually, even the party doesn't matter. They're saying it's the local candidate that is going to weigh on the minds of the voter. Will it be the local candidate that is the current incumbent? Is it up against, or is he up against a strong candidate? That is what is going to matter. Employment, remember, we saw that play out in UP as well, and that is a key issue here in Maharashtra. Of course, Maharashtra, the agrarian stress has been accentuated by the fact that there has been a drought, and many districts have been declared drought prone in the state of Maharashtra. Graduates there working as helpers, so that clearly is going to be something that will weigh on the minds of voters as they look forward to the election. But we'll take a break. When we return, head to Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu. Jude, give us a quick heads up of what's coming up.
Well, for a start, we're in the southernmost tip of India at Cape Comorin in Kanyakumari, where an intense poll battle is heating up between incumbent MP and the BJP's only MP in Tamil Nadu, by the way, Pon Radhakrishnan, its Union Minister of Shipping, versus H. Vasanthakumar, also Tamil Nadu's richest candidate belonging to the Congress Party. More on that when we return. Keep watching Election Exchange on CNBC-TV18.
Time now for us to head to Kanyakumari. This is the only place in Tamil Nadu where the BJP managed to win in 2014. The incumbent MP, Radhakrishnan, has a battle on his hands. Jude Sane joins us now from Kanyakumari. Jude, how's the battle shaping up?
Well, it's heating up, I can most certainly tell you, especially in Tamil Nadu's unforgiving summer, where the BJP's incumbent MP and its MOS for shipping, Pon Radhakrishnan, is facing off against Tamil Nadu's richest MP candidate from the Congress Party. Now, more interestingly, Kanyakumari is known to be a communally sensitive constituency in Tamil Nadu, but the minister and the incumbent MP, Pon Radhakrishnan, told me a little earlier today that as far as minority voters are also concerned, they are pretty much on his side. Let's listen into a slice of that conversation.
We are going to win this conference. See, you all, you are asking about the boiling. Nothing is boiling here except the hearts of the opposition parties, mainly the Congress party. Mm-hmm. All others are very cool. Mm-hmm. They have decided to re-elect BJP here. Mm-hmm. So there is no problem.
Your opposition candidate, Vasanthakumar, said that you were partial towards Hindu students offering scholarships only to a certain section of the community. What is your response to such allegations?
Sir, this was happened only because of Congress, because of their partition attitude. They didn't give for the Hindu students. The minority leaders, the Christian bishops and leaders from all the minority communities, they also told this scholarship should be given to Hindu students also. But unfortunately, the Congress was not ready for that.
The DMK is saying that last election when you won, they and the Congress weren't united, votes were split. But this time there's a clear and solid alliance that's going to work against you, combined votes. Is that a factor that will be weighing in on your mind heavily?
Don't underestimate or don't give a mismeaning for the minority.
But combined votes not a factor against you?
They are with me. The Christian community is also voting for me.
Okay.
How can they say that they are totally voting for the Congress candidate? It's a wrong thing. Last time also I got 10,000 fishermen vote. Mm-hmm. Totally they are Christians.
Right.
Other side also from the mainland also. They were in support of me. Mm-hmm. This time also they are seeing the development activities here. Mm-hmm. So you are going to win with a very big margin. Right.
Last question before I let you go. So the Congress manifesto came out yesterday. Wealth and welfare talks about a separate Kisan budget, talks about 6% into education. Major promises with regard to both the wealth and welfare with regard to the country. Is that going to be a little bit of an impediment towards the progress of the BJP in Tamil Nadu?
This separate budget for the farmers was first introduced by the BJP government in Karnataka. Nobody should forget that.
Not at the center though.
And center, there is a time. We are for that. We are not against that. Our leaders will decide that and they will. Otherwise also, we are giving much importance for the agriculture and farmers' welfare.
Right.
So we are for that. But in what way we are to support them, whether going for a separate budget or not, that is different.
Well, we all love a classic BJP versus Congress battle, don't we? But on the other hand, facing off against Pon Radhakrishnan will be Tamil Nadu's richest MP candidate, H. Vasanthakumar, the owner of Vasant & Co., a rather popular chain of electronic outlets as far as Chennai and Tamil Nadu is concerned, has declared total assets of 412 crore rupees and will of course be contesting on a Congress ticket. Now, not only is Vasanthakumar confident of winning in Kanyakumari, but also says that he'll do it by a 3 lakh vote margin. Let's listen to a slice of the conversation that I had with Vasanthakumar a little earlier today. Vasanthakumar, you're facing off against the sitting MP of Kanyakumari, the only seat where the BJP is in power as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned. How confident are you going into the polls?
No, the only MP also given the false promise to the public.
Okay.
So he has not won the election with truth.
Okay.
He has given false promise. That is, that Hindu students are there, that poor students, they were, Radhakrishnan told, then I will get benefit to the people, that means scholarship to the Hindu people also.
Right.
So thousands of people assembled, then they cast their vote to these barons and also cast their votes to Radhakrishnan.
So unkept promises, that is the major concern.
Yes, yes.
Okay. I have to ask you, the last time though, poll experts are saying the BJP won Kanyakumari because the Congress and the DMK were not on the same side of the ballot. Now both the Congress and DMK are in alliance. Does that make you more confident?
100% we are going to win, and also more than 3 lakhs margin, and also now DMK and MDMK, two communists, and also Vidudhalai Sirutaigal, Muslim League, all the parties are joined together and fight against Radhakrishnan. We are going to win more than 3 lakhs votes difference than Radhakrishnan.
Yesterday your party leader released the Congress manifesto, wealth and welfare. How are you taking that promise to the people of Kanyakumari?
Sir, not only Kanyakumari, Tamil Nadu people are taking very eager to know that how our Rahul Gandhi invert all those things and deliver this one. First is 6,000 rupees to the poor people and 72,000 rupees per year to the people. 33% to the women for government jobs. And also he has given that people, those who are afraid of that NEET exam,
yes,
that should be abolished.
Okay.
And also that loan borrowed by farmers also going to be waived.
Well, that is the Congress candidate in Kanyakumari, hoping that the alliance will work the trick this time around and the Congress and the DMK will be able to trounce the BJP. Remember that the BJP is holding that one seat there in Kanyakumari in the state of Tamil Nadu. This is also an election that will depend on how alliances shape up on the ground. The Congress has been able to ink that alliance with the DMK in Tamil Nadu and with the JDS in Karnataka as well as one in Bihar. So the Congress hoping that these alliances will deliver the goods for the party. But we will continue to track many of these hotly contested battles across different states in India on the election caravan. What are the issues that matter to you, the people of India? We will give a platform to the people of India to voice their opinion ahead of the elections, ahead of the 11th of April when the first phase kicks off. The election caravan will stop tonight for today, but we will continue to roll through rural India. Do keep watching CNBC-TV18.